Welcome back to the Barbell Medicine YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Jordan Feigenbaum. We have Dr. Austin Baracchi in the studio, live, in the flesh. That's real. He's in town this week, and we decided to answer some questions from the internet. Can lower weights produce similar adaptations if pre-fatigued when the RPE is the same? So I think this question is like, if you're fatigued, right, or otherwise your performance potential is lower on a given day, can the reduced load that you're necessarily having to use to maintain RPE drive similar adaptations than if you had a high performance day, but RPE was still the same? And my answer to that is, yeah. I mean, that's the whole point of using RPE, is that you get the correct dose of training stress to drive the fitness adaptations that you want. And so you want something that's the same level of exertion at the same rep scheme, you know, same rest intervals, because that's going to produce the same or similar adaptations. And when you go look in the literature, there's a much wider range of acceptable training intensities that drive, in this case, strength adaptations. And when you talk about hypertrophy adaptations, that gets even wider, which is why you can have, you know, varying rep schemes that will produce hypertrophy. So
I think the easiest way to think about this is to consider the converse scenario where you don't lower the weight when you're extremely fatigued, right? Mm-hmm. It stays real heavy, and then it's just a lot harder. Mm-hmm. You're probably not able to do the same number of reps.
The volume goes down.
Or if you are, again, the RPE, maybe instead of being 7, it's 11, that, right? That is very obviously going to generate different adaptations, as well as generating way more of what we called previously the negative kind of consequences, the fatigue cost and things like that. So if you just imagine the other scenario where you just ignore the effects of fatigue and you just throw the weight on the bar anyway, that's obviously going to generate different adaptations and different costs compared to adjusting the weight based on where your performance is at that time.
Yeah, it's just putting too much of an emphasis on the absolute load, because it's like the whole reason for using RPE is to effectively arrive at a similar intensity, like a relative intensity on a given day with changing performance.
Yeah.
So it's like, let's say that the RPE that you're using for the rep scheme is, you know, wants you to use somewhere between 70 to 75% of your one rep max. And on a day when you have high level of performance, that happens to be heavier.
Yeah.
But on a day when you have reduced level performance, it's lower. It's like, okay, well, it's still 70 to 75%.
Yep.
It's just your 1 RM change for the day.